they can get into the Eve. At sabi mo nga, Falling Star Moon. Tapos meron kang Benedetta. And it's gonna take Imba DJ to have a perfect game sa kanyang paggamit ng ultimate kung ayaw niya mahuli. And it's gonna be difficult
if
for sure.
Merong way, ladies and gentlemen, para ilabas ni Imba DJ lahat-lahat, the time is now. We head on to the Celestial Palace para dito sa game number one ng Signal Ultra versus Work Oster Force.
Yeah, makikita natin na maganda ang early game potential coming out from Work Oster Force. Para naman sa Signal Ultra, mabilis sila mag-take ng jungle. Question is, kaya ba nila ma-outspeed?
Uy!
Kailangan maganda ang start kay Bensanity. Already burning yung flicker, tapos na-stun lang siya for that matter. So, you don't want that. Kasi nahatak ni Archeezy yung payong saktong-sakto.
Mm-hmm. Itatandaan mo, kapag ka nagsama yung payong at si Kagura, oh, laging merong stun effect na yes, bumabalot doon. And dito sa may taas, looking at this certain matchup, tingin ko naman magiging safe lang din si Kosei dito. Alam niya na magkakaroon talaga ng certain edge dito. Yung ooh, Joe, but three Martizzi, aggressive plays coming out here for the side of Work Oster Force.
Very good, very well done. And Work Oster Force, we're talking about the matchup dun sa my top lane, and Esmeralda and Joe. I remember there's a meme, or hindi naman meme, pero kumala din to na parang copy pasta from one of our good friends, si Idol at JTZ. Never daw mananalo ang Joe sa Esmeralda into the side lanes. And oh, I quote. At I kind of want to say, I agree. Makikita naman natin na dahil dun sa Avarice na meron ng isang Esmeralda, tapos naka-purify din siya. So, yung battle spells pa lang, yung impact dun sa mismong lane, masasabi mo na hindi mananalo sa lane yung Cho against the Esmeralda.
Mm-hmm. And that is going to be pretty much kapag ka nagkawa mo na yung mga skills mo. Kapag ka level 1, medyo talaga nagkakaroon ka ng problema. It's all about timing, yeah, and all that. Arteezy! Nahuli siya, yung crystal was put into play. Napakagad ng crystal coming up from Imba DJ.
Oh, movement up top lane from Work Oster Force. I like this a lot. Si Chu, imbis na mag-focus siya sa kills, tinatanggalan niya ng mga green jungle yung part ng Signal Ultra.
It's pretty much something na expect mo sa Work. And tatandaan mo, punishment. Grabe yung setup dito ng Signal Ultra. Yung commit nila dito sa skirmish na to, actually, apat na tao pinadala nila agad. At andito na rin si Kosei. At kung titignan mo doon sa taas, merong, sabi dito ni Janus, sige, susubukan ko na lang kunin kung ano man makukuha ko dito. And 3 Martizzi, with his help, nagawa nila to. Chu, nandito sa gilid, mahanap siya ni Aqua Boy Thornrose to dodge yung physical attack. Wow!
And that meant na si Aqua Boy bigla magiging low. At naging awkward na bigla yung pag-take ng Turtle. Eventually, mawko pa siya ni Arteezy. Work Oster Force. Lahat ng kanilang mga players nag-pop off noong time na yon.
Grabe yung pinapakita ng Work dito. Lahat ng pwedeng gulang na gawin, mm-hmm, sa laban na yon, ginawa nila. It's not a matter of nasa kalamangan sila. Si Chu, napakababa na yung buhay doon. Actually, tipan mo na nga lang si Chu doon. Tapos na yun eh. But still, Thornrose, well-timed, lahat na.
Oo.
And they just got away with that.
Cooldown din kasi yung mga skills ni Roger at that point na hindi rin niya naamoy, kumbaga kung nasa na si Chu. But with the Thornrose, tapos get...
Nakuha
pa ni Arteezy.
Oo nga, tama nga yung mga pinag-share, yung mga pinag-status ng mga pro player.
Anong sabi nila?
Flameshot is the new retry.
Flameshot is the new retry.
Oh, wala.
Grabe. Nakikita nyo naman yung pagnakaw na yan, the damage coming up flameshot just enough. Nagtitipid din naman kasi ng retribution. You'll understand bakit yung ibang mga junglers hindi agad nag-retry kahit meron, kahit cooldown. Kasi you wanna serve it for a crucial fight. Ginagamit kaya yan minsan pang slow. So sometimes pag masyado kang matipid, dun ka na nananakawan.
And nakikita na natin yung sinabi mo kanina, Wolf, yung Esmeralda Cho matchup kapag yeah, nakuha na ng levels dito si Kosei, automatically napupush back si Janus pabalik ng base.
Exactly. And mamaya makikita natin sa gold for sure na mataas na yung gold ni Kosei.
And eto ha, si Bensanity nagkaroon pa ng commit. Dalawang ultimate yung ginamit, yung Way of the Dragon, tsaka yung Unstoppable Force. And yet si Kosei, yeah, dahil nag-conserve siya doon, nagamit niya yung Purify niya para doon sa Unstoppable Force. Rhea naman ang pinaka-next target nila dito, and that's not going to be a setup na makakatakas pa siya.
Yep. And round number 2, this time wala na Purify.
eto kaya na nila to. At sabi ni Aquaboy, tutulong na rin ako, may Wave the Dragon pa, and hindi niya na kinuha yung last hit. Binigay niya na kay Aquaboy kasi alam niya, nag-struggle si Aquaboy ngayon to get yung kills, and nawawalan din kasi siya ng buffs eh.
Yep. I wanna say, ang ganda ng pag-conserve naman ni Janus at that moment in time. He's able to land the Wave the Dragon ng tamang-tama. However, where goes their force? Confident sa pag-take ng turtle easily. And that is the second turtle going in favor of Work. Yung una ay nakuha ni Kagura. This time, sabi ni Mensanity, okay, nagawa na nung isang beses, hindi na makakaulit.
Now, Work, Oster Force. Kung nakikita mo yung pressure sa mapa, parang may pressure points lagi sa mapa dito pagka-Work eh. Tapos lagi nila pinipindot yun. Kung mapapansin mo, si Trimar TZ dito, mahuhuli siya ng Daytona's Welcome. Ang tanong, masasalba pa siya ni Unravel? Unravel dito, nasa range, binigyan niya ng option si Trimar na mag-dash out. Kukunin niya yun at susubukan pa nila kumuha ng kills doon sa initiation na sinimula ng Signal Ultra.
And this is macro coming out from Work Oster Force kasi tingnan mo, magkakat dito si Kosei. And then, that will force them to go to the mid lane. Pagdating nila dun sa may mid, hindi magiging handa yung Signal Ultra at makapag-farm din naman or makakuha sila ng kill this time. Kaso, kakaibang decision. Biglang nagbago yung decision ng Work Oster Force. Instead, magpa-farm na lang sila. I thought that they will go for a kill kasi ganun yung movements nila eh.
Mm-hmm. At si Rhea dito ang naging ally at tutumba rin naman si Trimar TZ. That's going to be a shutdown para kay Trimar at mapupunta yung bounty nun kay Aquaboy.
Well, I think Work Oster Force, that was a weird play. But at the same time, mukhang gusto lang nila talaga mabigyan ng or maghintay ng item para kay Chu. I think they're waiting for the proper timing. Pati na rin dun sa Esmeralda. So that when the next turtle comes, which is about 20 seconds from now, mas lalamang pa rin sila. Ayun nga, naghihintay nga sila. Karami ti Reaper now available for Kosei.
Alam mo, Wolf, I do agree, may mga weird plays na nangyari, pero sa lahat ng nangyari ngayong MPL Season 7 PH, may masasabi ka ba bang weird? Parang lahat na lang, tatanggapin mo na lang.
Kailangan talaga tanggapin mo na lang. Look at this, Kosei is 4.8k already. Almost 5k ng 7 minutes. Napakabilis ng farm.
Dito mo makikita na nag-shine yung mga players like Trimar TZ. Yung mga play nila na ganito, na parang talagang lagi silang nagpipilit ng kalamangan. Ang ganda nun. And wala siyang eye for an eye. Hindi niya madadudge yung damage na ginawa dito ni Aquaboy. And that is going to be a kill, another kill, para dito kay Aqua. Now, Trimar TZ, hindi mo din siya masisisi eh. Kasi alam niya yung kalamangan niya ngayon. Alam niya na lamang siya. Pagpipilit talaga siya eh.
And ang problema nga lang eh, so Work Oster Force ang nakuha ng mas magandang trade-off. Dominance Eyes from Unravel. I like this a lot. Kasi ito yung way para hindi ka ma-burst down ng Cho, pati na rin ng ating Roger. And then even with Jawhead, diba, yung some physical damage output from there, it kind of makes it so na si Unravel ay mas confident na. Hindi mo na siya nag-anti-magic item kasi alam niya na initial burst talaga kami na from Signal Ultra is all physical. And eventually, Work Oster Force nakakuha na naman ng turret sa may bottom lane. And by the way, sila din yung nakakuha ng third turtle.
And Unravel, nahuli siya ng Unstoppable Force, Circling Eagle, catching out 3! And that is going to be a fight, ladies and gentlemen. At Trimar TZ, nasa gitna sila. The flickers come out. Sword Intent comes out as well. At dito natin nakikita kung paano sasagutan ng Work Oster Force yung real world manipulation. Flickers, dashes, aalis sila doon. Hindi sila may paglaban.
Good thing that Work Oster Force did not overly commit. Nararamdaman mo na eh, pwede nila dive. Lalong-lalong na with the lead that they have. But yung pagka-activate pa lang ng real-world manipulation, automatically nag-out na rin yung mga members ng Work Oster Force. And now, you can see Work Oster Force, maganda yung macro game nila. If you'll notice the minion waves, it's always on the side of Signal Ultra. Meaning to say, lagi naka-push out yung mga minions ng Work.
This is going to be a great pick-off pag magawa nila to, Circling Eagle. Grabe si Unravel. Ito na nga yung sinasabi mo, the Dominance Eyes is put into play.
That's right. Good scene si Unravel na boy pa rin. Tapos ginamit pa yung some invulnerability frames courtesy of the ultimate. Perfect para mapag-survive. Ito yung masasabi mo talaga nakabisado yung Matilda pick. Most teams struggle against Works Matilda kasi si Unravel alam niya kung paano mag-itemize.
And at the same time, yung paggamit ng mga maliliit na bagay to your advantage, yung mga frames na yan. And yes, it only takes about a half a second, a split second lang siya. But still, the fact remains, kung alam mo kung kailan pipihitin yun, that's going to be a matter of life and death para sa'yo.
Exactly. Now, Lord, gonna be taken by Work Oster Force for now. Ang ganda, tingnan mo yung mga pwesto ni Tree Martizi as to zone them out. Pero sa likuran,
Janus, with that play, Chu will get out. Phantom Execution, ginamit niya din. And Flame Shot to force people out. Aqua Boy dito, Roger Titol. Ito na yung damage output at pinagmamalaki niya dito. And that is going to be extra, extra hard for him to go that way kasi nga, hindi na shred yung buhay dito ng mga members sa side ng Work. And look at this, Chu getting away with style.
Na isusulat, Kuya Butters, sa aklat ng Aether, ang counter sa Roger Tol, Lancelot.
Lancelot.
Lancelot, okay?
Okay.
At nakita niyo ngayon si Chu, masterful usage of the Lancelot, but nevertheless, yung ginawa din ng Work Oster Force na composure, presence of mind na nung nilikuran na sila nila Janus, ay nag-disperse muna sila at naghintay ng mga tamang timing para bumalik ulit sa laban. There was also one hero from Work Oster Force that went for the Eve. At maganda rin na play yun gamit na from Work Oster Force. Kasi ngayon, dahil hindi na ganun ka-effective yung physical damage sa Signal Ultra, de-depende na sila ngayon kay Imba DJ to dish out the damage. But unfortunately, for Signal Ultra, Work Oster Force, mas maganda yung composure nila in that specific clash.
At ang daming adjustments na ginawa dito ni Imba DJ in terms of items. Hindi nga siya nag-Clock of Destiny first. Mm-hmm. Ang kinuha niya agad dito, yung Durance.
That's right.
Kasi kailangan talaga nilang sumabay dun sa sustain at kailangan din nila makakuha ng kills. But the fact remains, Work Oster Force, hindi lang yun yung kailangan nila para talagang, hindi lang yun yung kailangan ng Signal para matali yung Work dito. As a lot of these heroes, ang gaganda na ng items.
Yeah, that's why I feel like the Matilda is a much better first pick compared to the Joy. Although parang equal lang din eh. Kaso yung Signal Ultra, maintindihan mo kung bakit yung Joy yung pinili nila instead of the Matilda. Kaso nga lang, duly punished ang Signal Ultra as Work Oster Force. Really, having so much comfort now. Ang komportable nila eh. May healing sila, may taga-face check. Tapos si RTZ with the Benedetta, ang ganda ng map control niya. And look at the positioning, nag-adjust yung Work. Kanina kasi dun sila nalikuran ni Janus. This time, bago mag-Lord, dun muna sila pumuesto.
Meron silang memory dito na hindi sila makakalimot. Twice is too much. And RTZ, nahuli ng Crystal! Bensanity! The Hidden Mitsurugi! Ladies and gentlemen, nilabas na ang tamang patalim! Kosei, hinahabol ni Janus, sinusuntok-suntok. Aqua Boy, nasa may pinakagilid. Damage output after damage output. Andito na si Rhea, yung dinosaur, kinagat si Unravel!
Oh my goodness! What a play!
Janus! Janus with another play. Knock-up play para dito kay RTZ. Kosei, nilalabanan niya pa sila Rhea. At doon na matatapos yung fight na yon. Ang gandang plays coming out here from Signal Ultra.
Well, Signal Ultra taking advantage of territorial control. Parang ganun eh, nilapagan eh. But this instant replay is brought to you by Oppo A94. Experience gaming at full speed with Oppo A94. Get yours now for only 13,999. Timing is key. Tingnan si Bensanity. And even kay Imba DJ, wala knock-up even. Nag-control na yon, saktong-sakto nakuha yung Lord. But then again, real-world manipulation, ito talaga yung pinakasulit. Kasi halos lahat ng mga members ng Work Oster Force ay nandun. Do take note, bago ka makalabas dun sa box, masastun ka muna. Kaya nga naman, nung tinry nila umalis, lalo pa silang nayari. And now, the timing is perfect. Bigla from Signal Ultra. My goodness.
And Signal, sila ang nagpo-push ngayon. Nakikita nyo na ang Hiten Mitsurugi ng Signal Ultra, ang natatagong patalim.
Natatagong si Bensanity.
Oh.
Yun lang pala kailangan.
Tatandaan mo, ano ba yung gamit na skin niyan, Joyed na yan? Samurai skin yan.
Samurai skin
yan. Yan yung patalim.
Saan ba nang galing ang Hiten Mitsurugi ni Bensanity?
Wag na natin pag-usapan.
Wag na natin pag-usapan. Pero kasi guys, nakausap namin siya dun sa bootcamp raid ng Signal Ultra. I wanna say for Bensanity, siya sa mga pinaka light yung mood. Masabi ko.
Parang
masayahing tao, palabiro kumbaga. But when he plays the Jawhead, or at least playing the tank for the team, no, na tayo makakita ng kakaiba. Ito kasi inaabangan natin from Signal Ultra.
Uy, Tremar!
Standout performances.
Tremar, ang ganda ng pwesto ng Signal. That is going to be the brush play. Mm-hmm. If ever may tao doon na malapit lang doon sa area that could have done yung physical damage,
that's right.
Kahit pa paano ng onte, I think kill na yun eh.
Yeah. It could have been really a kill. Ang question lang is, did they really have to commit yung ultimate aim ba, DJ? Ang work of Star Force, mas magiging confident na ngayon sa paggalaw sa mapa. Holy Crystal on Kagura, masakit na to.
At nahuli si Kosei. And that could have been a good play if ever wala lang ditong dash na binibigay yung Matilda. Naka-counter din yung Crystal eh.
Ooh, nahatak nila si Unravel.
Uy, dito na ba yung pinakalikod? Unravel dito, the Matilda will be the first one to go down, I think, but he stays alive. Dominance, Ice, tanky items, Matilda staying alive. And look at this, Daytona's welcome, dinilaan, at dinura, pak! Tumba! At Roger Titol getting that kill.
That's interesting kasi yung work of Star Force, they spent so much time na hiwalay ng Signal Ultra by baiting Unravel to pop the ultimate. Ito sa may backlines.
Oh my goodness, look at the damage output coming out here from the side of Signal. Pero work, lumalaban. Kosei nandun sa likod. Pinipilit niya talagang pwersahin yung mga members ito ng Signal. And Lance will get the kill on Jawhead. Aqua Boy, siya yung next target. Three Martizi, susubukan nilang i-clean up dito kung sino man yung natitira sa side ng Signal Ultra. Ooh. And Badij with a flicker play. Thorn Rose, tatama. And that is going to be Aqua Boy. Round number three. Round three na to actually. And Janus Aqua Boy, babalik pa ba sa round number 4? Pakamdam ko hindi na.
And Three Martizi really paying dividends. Kanyang timing. Now Chu wants to punish Rhea. Do they have the burst? Meron silang stun. Under the turret, nag-miss yung Alex. No blow, but it's gonna be a kill onto Rhea for sure. Bigla na lang naka-turn around ang Work Oster Force. And this is something that Signal Ultra should be avoiding. Oo, nakakuha sila ng malaking knockout. But this time, this is 3 versus 5 butters.
Alam mo, Wolf, yun din yung nagiging problema talaga ng Signal eh. May mga moment of brilliance sila na pagka nagkaroon ng team fight, sobrang ganda talaga na napapakita. But meron silang mga plays na nagagawa kaya hindi nila naku-close out yung game.
Do take note na mas maunat na ngayon ang Lord compared before. Lalong-lalo na pag 17 minutes or 15 minutes above, dun yung deal breaker eh.
And oy, yung minion sa taas, wala rin diff. Oh my goodness, okay. Kakayanin ba to?
Do take note, 50% less damage na ang ginagawa ng minion sa base ngayon.
And that is going to work, madedef pa nila. And value play coming out from work. Bensanity nasa gitna. Tinapon niya dito si RTZ para ma-stun yung mga members dito ng work. Pero hindi enough yon. Sobrang mobile ng mga heroes na humahabol sa kanya. At si Barats, nandun sa gilid. Hinahabol pa rin nila Unravel, Chu, and the others will just go back. Masyado talaga makunat si Rhea dito.
I love the turn that you use. Value play. Dahil mas maganda yung trade-off para sa work Oster Force.
RTZ and the others, they're making it happen. At kahit kamuntikan nang magkaroon dito ng play na mananalo na sana yung Signal, remember, binaba na yung damage ng minions sa base. If ever nangyari yun sa previous patch, Wolf, tapos na itong laro to.
50% less damage. As you notice, kung dati ko opinion, ang bilis matunaw ng base dahil lang sa minions. But in that moment, 50% less, twice the amount of time na kinailangan. At ngayon, may problema ng work ang Signal Ultra defending.
Mm-hmm. At eto na ang sinasabi natin, nandun yung payong sa gitna at babalik dito yung work. Hindi nila ipipili to. Alam nila, kailangan din nila mag-ingat. Remember, respawn timers, napakalaking factor na yan ngayon. Nagiging malaking factor na rin yan. So, might as well, kumuha ka na lang ng value, kuha ka na isang turret, tapos mag-back ka, kaysa naman, mapitas ka doon dahil nag-overextend ka, tapos yung dead timer hindi na, na nakapanig sa'yo.
Look at this, Hunter Strike picked up after the Oracle, para kay 3 Martizi to survive, and then added movement speed, tapos syempre overload when it comes to the damage. I think counted din naman yung mga ibang damage procs coming out from the other skills of the Benedetta. Kaya ang interesting na bono na yun, mas maganda yung pag-take ng Lord. But now, Work Oster Force, evidently, sila na yung mas nakapag-control natin mapa. You can see the items now. Puro pakunat yung kay Unravel, naturally, dahil siya yung roamer or yung tank. While on the side of Signal Ultra, tingnan mo yung itemization dito ni Aqua Boy. All damage. Well, this time, my brute force breastplate, pero all throughout, almost damage talaga gusto niyang gawin.
And kailangan mag-ingat dito ni Aqua Boy, siya yung pwedeng mabatuhan ng payong dito. And that is going to be Kosei. Ginamitan siya na dito. Let's welcome. Purify is there. Bensanity. First casualty. Doon matatapos yun.
That is a weird fight that Signal Ultra really brought in. Although maintindihan mo eh, kasi maganda yung confined spaces para sa Signal Ultra. Kaso ngayon, mahihirapan sila mag-defend. They don't have the ultimate anymore from the Eve.
Arteezy pumasok at hindi siya mapunish ng todo. Aqua Boy, binatuan ng Falling Star Moon. Yung dash niya just in the nick of time. Pati yung flame shot, kung natamaan siya ng Falling Star Moon, that could have been a game changer para sa side ng work.
Narinig yata tayo ng Aqua Boy, bigla siya nag-Athena Shield. Naintindihan niya na may burst potential na si Arteezy. Masakit na yung damage output and ayaw mong magulat noon. What three Arteezy going back to the Queen's Wings. Kumukunat na yung mga heroes dito ng parehas na teams. Kaya makes it so na yung Work Oster Force Galak ay mas mataas yung mas madaming choices of damage. Meron damage si 3 Arteezy, si Kosei nandyan, Chu also deals damage, pati na rin si Arteezy. When you look at the side of Signal Ultra, medyo nasa pakunat lang yung ibang mga parts ito. Like, for sure, Imba DJ and Aqua Boy can dish out damage. Now, kailangan na si Janus mag-step up. So far, 0-1 and 4 on this Cho na naka-high and dry. You kinda need more. You're asking for more sa gold laner ngayon ng Signal Ultra.
Everyone needs to step up kapag ka 20 minutes na yung game. Lahat kayo may items na. Lahat kayo may gagawin na. At lahat kayo may kaya ng i-burst. It's just a matter of pinpointing kung sino nga ba yung kailangan mong mahuli. Ako naniniwala ako sa mga kailangan mahuli dito yung Lance.
Yeah, Lancelot for sure.
If ever mahuli niya yung Lance dito, I'm thinking that is going to be a major, sabihin natin, swing para sa side ng Signal Ultra. Pero katulad nga na sinabi natin, narinig na naman tayo ata ni Chu. Kumuha ng immortality. Yeah.
Actually, binenta na niya yan, tapos binili niya ulit. Kanina, napatay siya dun sa, nung nag-dive sila dun sa may mid lane, na-burn niya yung immortality. This time, bumili na ulit siya. And I think hindi pa yata din cooldown. So that's 210 seconds, which means that's what? 3.5 minutes?
Oh, 3.5. Oh. Those are the things talaga na napakalaking bagay. Pero alam mo, nandito na sila sa
area. What?
Aqua Boy with the retribution. That is going to be another steal. And it's a day of steals, ladies and gentlemen. Rhea dito. Nilalabanan ang apat na member ng Work Oster Force mag-isa. Unravel, napaka-aggressive. Hinahabol yung tatlong member na natira.
Pagalingan, Rumetri. Pagalingan, Flame Shot. Pagalingan mag-invade, puro nakawan ang tema ngayong linggo, Butters.
Nakawan ang tema, tama ka dyan, Wolf. Pero, ang tanong, mananaig ba yung signal sa ganung play nila? Kasi minsan, kailangan mo din talagang samahan yan ng tikas eh.
Well, at least they will survive to see another day. Yung Work Oster Force, magiging busy sila sa pag-take ng Lord. Do take note, mas maunat na ang Lord sa ngayon compared from before kasi nagsiscale na nga ang damage, ang pagpakunat, even yung gold na binibigay ng Lord ngayon, much better from before, kapag 15 minutes and up. Yung nagiging deal breaker nga nandito is pag late game na talaga, pagandahan na ng pag-secure doon sa Lord.
Si Janus dito, naghahanap na gumawa ng ano, naghahanap na ng play. Nagde-death brush na siya. Ayan o. Oo.
Magawa na ano, hinahabol ang pangarap.
Hinahabol niya na ang pangarap. Eto na. May dadaan ba? Yun ang tanong.
Hindi magpapaloko.
Kasi kanina, malapit si Lance. Kung nagkamali, ng daan si Lance ng, ano, ng brush, feeling ko may masisipa eh.
Tama ka dyan. At even when you have so much items, yung gantong klase ng Cho na kasi, lalo na naka-high and dry, tapos 23 minutes na full pack na rin yung Cho, kaya na makapag one combo finish. One hit combo. Parang hindi ako naniniwala doon sa one hit combo eh, kasi parang siya naging combo kung one
hit lang siya. Pero one hit combo.
Pero technically one hit combo.
One hit combo. Meron ganun.
Oo.
Oh, pero alam mo, kung papasinin mo yung galaw dito ni Chu sa mapa, wala siyang binibigay na kahit ano dito para sa ano, sa work, sa signal pala. Literal na nililimas nila yung buffs ng kalaban.
Yeah.
And at the same time, si Chu din, umiikot din siya doon sa may gubat nila to the point na chinecheck niya kung meron bang naggugubat doon na kalaban.
Exactly. At this point, ito na yung tinasabi nating macro battle. Kasi 24 minutes na. Pwede mong gawin ay lumamang ka dun sa mapa para yung kalaban mo ay kahit hindi pa natatalo, hindi rin naman napag-farm. So walang progression yung itemization or yung map control, which kind of means that even when you're not really winning, nanalo ka pa rin.
Nanalo ka pa rin. And yun yung jungle choke. Mm. And sometimes, kasi sabihin mo kahit may lumalapit namang minions eh. Oh. At times kasi yung minions na yun, nahati yun sa tatlo, exactly. Nahati yun sa lima. You can't really funnel it into someone kapag ka naghahati-hati na lahat. At yun na lang yung resources na meron kayo.
Ang binibuild mo kasi din yung gap ng economy.
Gap, yeah.
Kasi pag kinuhaan mo ng farm yung kalaban, bukod sa yung mayaman ka, sila, hindi sila nakakuha ng additional na gold. Which means na ang lumalaki talaga is yung gap mo when it comes to the gold. Hindi yung actual gold mo lang. Yung difference nyo when it comes to the farming.
Nako, si Janus na pinalo ng tela. pinalo ng tela. Although, meron siyang innate tankiness din naman dahil nga nasa late-late game na tayo. 25 minutes. Kung sino man ang mahuli dito at tumumba, magti-tiktok.
Makikita natin yung Esmeralda ni Kose dito. Masakit na talaga yung damage. I think ito, building itemization. Building damage items. Kaya naman, kahit may Athena shield si Janus, nasaktan pa rin siya. By the way, tatlo yung, lima yung Athena shield on the side of Signal Ultra. What a dodge!
3 Martizi!
What a dodge!
Grabe din yung mechanics ito ni 3 Martizi.
Presence of mind.
Presence of mind. At eto, dito mo nakikita yung mga players talaga na, alam mo yun, pag pumasok na sila sa zone, mm-hmm. parang anything na bato mo sa kanila, kaya nila i-dodge. Eto na yung mga pressure moments or yung mga sobrang naka-pressure na moments dito sa game na to. And some break, some go above it, and some medyo nagiging, nandun lang sila sa gitna. Pero alam mo, si Janus, nag-break siya dun sa pressure na yun. Habang naghahanap siya ng sarili niyang pick-off. Yun naman yung single win. Minus 1 yun. This is a 4v5. This is going to be theoretically easy Lord para sa side ng work. Pero yung work, sabi nila dito, hindi kami natatapos sa Lord lang. Pipilit din namin kayo i-take down. Real world manipulation. Kosei, nasa gitna. Look at the damage output. Nahuli dito at nakain. And Winter Truncheon is there! Arteezy, hindi siya masa-stun! Unravel trying to save him! At andito na rin si Unravel with a two-man stun! Grabe, pinapakita nila dito! Chu! Damage output! Phantom Execution! Rhea! Going down! Immortality pop! At eto na! Ang hinahanap na opening ng work, Auster Force! And this is game number one!
It's gonna be difficult. And it's Imba DJ, pero wala siyang ultimate. I wanna give that clash to 3 Martizi. I will explain that later. But look at si Chu. Power play against Imba DJ. Hindi nga lang matatapos. But I wanna say, really, hindi malalang work Auster Force if not for the movements of 3 Martizi. Hinanap niya agad yung likuran. Pinwersa niya si Imba DJ na mag-ulti. Tapos nakaalis pa siya. And then pag round 2 nung laban, siya pa rin yung nagpapanalo sa team.
Imba DJ, pinihit na yung real world manipulation.
Oh no.
Kakayaanin pa ba nila yung Death to Chu na Papi Immortality? Let us see. Lord is here in the area. And
oh,
grabe! Away kung away. Mechanical skills ko. Mechanical skills. And this is going to be work winning game number one. Grabe yung game na yun, Wolf.
My goodness. That Benedetta play coming out from 3 Martizi forcing so much of the commitments.